absolutely and unequivocally identified with is this land of Cush and the antiquity of Cush in Bereshit. I did a little poem maybe about 7 or 8 years ago that I want to share with you. Then the other part of this that we want to look at and examine is to look at this word Bereshit. We've spent a little time on it for Erev, the seventh day of Shemini Eretz, the eighth day. Spent a little time on it on Thursday on Shemini Eretz. Touched on it. I said I wanted to touch on it a little bit more on this Shabbat of Bereshit. So here we go. I want to give you as much as I can and as short a time as I can. Shabbat Shalom, call it out the name Israel. This is Shabbat that we begin anew the reading of our sacred text, the sacred Torah with Bereshit. In the beginning, Bereshit is a very interesting word because, as we have discussed at the end of Sukkot, as we read Bereshit, was in the Torah, the rejoicing of the Torah, we examined the word Bereshit. The numeric value of the word Bereshit is 913. But looking closer at the word Bereshit, we see that this one word of Torah, for in the beginning, contains several words that better help us understand and perhaps why this word was chosen to actually open up our sacred scripture. So let us take a closer look, please, at Bereshit. Beth, B, means in. Beth, Resh. Beth, Resh. Beth, Resh. That's the first two letters. Beth, Resh means, spells bar. Some understand it to mean sun, but it also means pure, P-U-R-E. Beth, Resh, Olive, spells bara. The word bara is the second word after Bereshit. It says Bereshit bara. So if you really say bara, bara. Bara simply means to create. But this idea of creation in bara is to create something from nothing. Bara also means to shape, or it means to form. What I love about it is bara can also mean to be fat. In other words, to be plentiful. Beit Aleph Ra. Ro'eh means seeing, or to be a seer. And Reish Aleph Shin, which spells Rosh, which means the head. Aleph Shin, Esh, means fire. Aleph, Esh, means fire. And Shin Yo, Shed, means a gift that is offered as homage. Shin Yo and Tav, spelling the word sheet, means garment, or it means to put or to set. So the word Bereshit could be understood to mean in the beginning, Hashem, who is pure, began shaping or forming creation, which is something from nothing. And he, the Holy One, saw that he needed fire to form the olive bay. As the head of all, he, the Holy One, blessed is his name, gave a gift to humanity, which is the garment that he formed from nothing, which we understand to be the universe that we are. which equals the same man to a rock. Or we could say that if you take the names of the patriarchs, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, when you spell their names in the Hebrew and you add the letters of their name in Hebrew, you have 13 letters. And while I tell you that the names of the patriarchs have 13 letters, so also do the names of the matriarchs, Sarah, Rivka, Raquel, and Leah. These four names of the matriarchs also contain 13 letters. When you take 13 and add 13 with that 13, you get the number 26. When you get 26, it gets the value of the name of the Eternal. Yud-Heh-Vav-Heh, which is 26. And 2 plus 6 equals 8. And 8 equals infinity or eternity. It means foreverness. It means unendedness. The first representative of humanity